What's going on, guys? Steele here. Thought I would give you a quick look at the GEC Great Eastern Cutlery model number 72. This is another one of their lockback designs, and I've had it a few days, and I thought I'd just go over it. This is a new, the Makarta handle on this is new for 2013, as I understand it. And I think it was around 80, 85 shipped, something like that. I got it from collectorsknives.net. Oops, phone's going off. So it's very nice. I've always loved Makarta as a handle material. It's not per se the flashiest, but even when it's wet, it's tacky without having to be sandpapery like G10. And this is a very nicely bolstered one. You can just see how nicely everything's finished on it. This one, there's a couple things I really want to show you guys. So this one is ground just as thin as the other number 99 that I have. This one is ground almost as lean as I think an Opinel that I've had before. Just very thin at the cutting edge. Almost zero ground. You can see they have a bevel on it, but you can barely see it. Just ever so slightly. This one has no side to side. It has, you know, just kind of your typical up and down on a lockback. I've never had a lockback that's not had some up and down, but I haven't ever handled like a custom or anything either. So the finish on these is really good, I think, for an $80 knife price point. You can see here the shield inlaid into the handle. It's like perfectly flush. No gaps. And from what I understand, Great Eastern Cutlery still pins their shields. Kind of a throwback to how they have always been done, not glued in. That's if Solo Knife Reviews is correct. A couple brass pins. I'm not sure if the liners are brass. I'm assuming that's what it is. You can see the Makarta. It's black Makarta. I'd love to see some variations. So in the hand, very comfortable for a hammer grip. Really comfortable in every grip that I've tried. This is nicely rounded off back here to fit into the palm well. And the only thing, and this is, I don't think I've ever had a production knife that didn't have this. The liners can be a touch sharp, but that's a really minor complaint. And there's a couple things I haven't done. This almost looked somewhat convex ground to me. The way the light kind of rolls on it, not really sure, but the other thing is that up here near the spine you can see where it's kind of rounded up through here, but that's fine either way. Even a flat grind at this thin geometry will do really well. So here's another testament. This really blew me away because I thought that this was pinned on the inside and then bolstered over. I'm gonna have to get it. Yeah, you can see right there, they've actually got that pin blended in. You can just barely catch it. I mean, from a distance, can't even tell. You really have to catch it in the right lighting. So, I'm really impressed with this for the like $25 price jump from the Delrin handled number 99. I think I would suggest this all day long. It comes in really nice bone-handled variations. And I don't know what else they use. They do some ivory. And now they're doing Makarta for this year, so maybe we'll see some other colors of that. But, alright guys, I've went on long enough. Let me know what you think. I don't know what's going on with new Google Plus YouTube layout and stuff, so comments seem really weird. I don't know. So, I'll see you guys in the next video.